Hello, in this video I would like to talk about the seven-sided die, the D7. And I would like to talk about the version which is based on pentagonal prism. How can this be a fair die? A fair die means that each side, the pentagonal base or rectangle sides, has equal chance to get land on it. How can this work? Well, imagine a pentagonal prism which is very, very thin, like a coin. If you throw it in the air, it will probably land on the one of the pentagonal base. Now imagine the same pentagonal prism which is very, very long. If you throw it in the air, probably it will always land on one of the rectangle sides, right? And somewhere between these two is the theoretical fair die under same circumstances. Because a lot of things may change this physics. Depend how you throw it, depend on the surface and similar, so that may affect the physics of the seven-sided die. So I built one, I designed it in the Fusion 360, I took a base of 15 millimeters of the pentagonal prism. The length I took 19.2 millimeters. So that's the height of the pentagonal prism, and I chamfered the edges with 1 millimeter, and this is the base, because theoretically in commercially available dies has same proportion, only I tried to round it to the metric values. I 3D printed one. It was very easy to 3D print one. I used the pentagonal base as a first layer. Edge of first layer is always sharper a little bit. I want equal edge on both sides of the base, so that's what I want to fix now. I will color the holes of the die with the marker. Even numbers will be with red, and odd numbers will be in black color. So this is number 5, 2, 4, 1, 3, 6, and 7. And then I did the test. I was throwing, I think, 250 times. And let's see the results. Very interesting results. Under same circumstances, it looks like we would need a die which is a little bit longer to reduce the chance to land on pentagonal bases. But this may change, depend I'm of the surface, for example, where do you use, how much does it bounce. I use the matting cut surface, but I noticed it works completely different on hardwood or maybe on some textile or carpet. Again, very, very different results I got. So I really don't like this die too much. It is not really a fair die. Definitely they cannot be used in casinos or something like that. But to play games in your family, they can be used, especially if everybody uses the same die, of course. If you want a real fair die, then you should use something like this. It is a prism, but not pentagonal prism, but the prism with seven sides. And there has to be very long to avoid landing on the base of this prism. In this case, each rectangular side is equal. So I built one, I just for fun, not with the numbers, but days of the weeks are on this die. Also, it can be downloaded from my website, mytechfun.com. You can see the link here. I optimized the design so it can be printed vertically, because in this case the first layer doesn't affect the important sides of the die. But it is very important to use a brim, because you need better grip to the bed. Touching surface may be too small.
And since the landed side doesn't have the opposite side, there is an edge, that's why I created actually those surfaces in the middle of the die where I created the holes for the letter of the days of the week. The brim is very easy to remove, and basically this die is ready to use. Only I used a permanent marker to color those holes for letters so it can be easier to read. And this is how it looks like now, one of my favorite die in my collection.
But why do I need a die like this? Well, it helps me make a decision. Okay, I'll fix that next week.
But when?
Hold on a second. Sunday. Sorry about that.
Oh God, never again.
Well, this was interesting, but I didn't enjoy it too much. I don't like these unsymmetric dice, like this D7. In next few videos I will play only with polyhedral dice, which are very very symmetric, each side is equal. And I hope you will follow me to that video too. Thank you for watching. Bye.